Good morning, students. I am Shivani Sharma, Assistant Professor in Botany, Government PG College for Women, Gandhinagar, Jammu. Today, I will be discussing the life cycle of mucor, which is the topic of first semester, Unit 3 and Subunit 3.2. Mucor belongs to class Zygomycetes, order Mucorales, family Mucoraceae. There are about 450 species which are grouped under 70 genera. Class Zygomycetes contain terrestrial molds which show a wide range of habitat. Mucor has about 40 species which are commonly found in soil, digestive system, plant surface, cheese. Now, mucor is a mold which is a type of fungi which is found everywhere. It is also called as dung mold, though it is saprophytic, that is, it grows in dead decaying matter, but it is also called as the coprophilous fungi, that is, dung loving fungi. But it also grows in variety of other habitats like bread, jams, jellies. The vegetative part of the mucor is eucarpic because in mucor, the thallus only differentiates into the reproductive structure. So when the thallus forms the reproductive structure, such type of thallus is called as eucarpic. The main reserve food material is glycogen and oil droplets. And plant body of mucor, the cell of the mucor, is mainly composed of cellulose and chitin. Now let us discuss the somatic structure of mucor. Here I will be discussing about the mycelium. The mycelium of mucor is highly branched and forms a fine network of hyphae. Hyphae are thread-like and forms very fine structure called mycelial network. They are of three types: the subterrane hyphae, the prostate hyphae, and the aerial hyphae. Please see the diagram. The subterrane hyphae, the prostate hyphae, and the aerial hyphae. The aerial hyphae are also called as sporangiophore. It is divided into a dome-shaped structure called as columella, and this columella, it has spores. The sporangium is round and thick outer covering which carries numerous spores inside it, and it may be globose to spherical in shape. The spores, they are the reproductive structure formed within the sporangium. They are simple, flattened, and variable in shape. Mucor shows both macroscopic as well as the microscopic features. Macroscopic features like we are able to see the colony with the naked eye. And the microscopic features include the sinusitic and branched hyphae, spores usually black in color. Mucor reproduces by all the three methods: the vegetative method, the asexual method, and the sexual method. The vegetative reproduction is simple and it usually occurs during unfavorable condition by the process of fragmentation. Now you can clearly see in this diagram, this is a vegetative cell of the mucor. It has divided into many parts and each part, so it is divided into 1, 2, and 3 parts, and each part has grown into a new vegetative cell. The asexual reproduction, it occurs by 3 types: the asexual reproduction by sporangiospores, asexual reproduction by chlamydospores, and asexual reproduction by oidiospores. The sporangiospores, they are the non-motile spores. So this is a vegetative hyphae of the mucor. So it has formed the the prostate hyphae, which are called as conidiospores. The conidiospores on maturation, it forms a columella, and the spores, the sporangium. Now on the rupture of this sporangium, the spores are generated, and each of the spore form the germ tube to form the vegetative hyphae. Sporangiospores, they usually arise singly and they are erect in position. You can see the single sporangiospore. On maturation, the cytoplasm of the nuclei push towards making the aerial hyphae swollen in form, swollen. And this is now, the swollen stage is called as sporangium. Now the sporangium has two parts, the columelloplasm and the sporoplasm. Sporoplasm is thick, dense, multinucleate. And columelloplasm is vacuolated and nucleated, and this is present towards the center. The cleavage occurs in the sporoplasm between the nucleus and the cytoplasm to form a thin walled multinucleate spores called as sporangiospores. The sporangiospores, they are then released. They are then released out because of the pressure, and on their release, they form a germ tube. Now, the second method is the asexual reproduction by chlamydospores. Chlamydospores, they are the hard wall that is formed inside the vegetative cell. So these are usually formed during unfavorable conditions. So in this diagram, you can usually see this is one chlamydospore, another chlamydospore. They are the thick walled chlamydospores. During unfavorable condition, the mycelium, it becomes septate and it accumulates the nucleus and cytoplasm. And then these spores, they get detached from the mycelium and remain dormant. On the onset of favorable condition, they germinate to form a new germ tube. Then next is the asexual reproduction by oidiospores. Unlike chlamydospores, oidiospores are thin-walled. They were thick-walled. So, and they are formed singly. They are formed just like the budding in yeast. So you can find out a pearl, small pearl. They are even smaller in size than the chlamydospore. So these pearls, thick pearls, they are released and on favorable condition, they form a germ tube and develops into the new individual. So let's, the oidiospore, they are formed at the tip. They are detached. They germinate to form a new individual. Now coming towards the sexual reproduction in mucor, it is specialized type and it occurs by the gametangial copulation. So how does it occur? Step one, the two thallus, one from the plus strain, another from the minus strain, comes in contact with each other. When they come in contact with each other, they develop a small outgrowth, which is called as protuberance. The wall between the protuberance, it breaks and it forms a progametangia. So when this outgrowth, what is the difference between protuberance and progametangia? When this protuberance, they swell up, they form the progametangia, and the progametangia then fuse. So when the wall breaks, they fuse, then they form the cenogamete. Ceno means after fusion. Okay, so these gametes are then called as cenogametes. Now cenogametes contain both strains. And these cenogametes then fuse to form a young zygospore. Okay, the zygospore is thick walled in color and it develops two walls. The outer wall is called as the exosporium, whereas the inner wall is called as the endosporium. The zygospore, it remains dormant for some time, and on the set of favorable condition, it forms the promycelium. Okay, and then this promycelium forms the mycelium. So that was all about the life cycle of mucor. So before I end up this lecture, let us recapitulate. Mucor reproduces by all the three methods: vegetative, asexual reproduction, and sexual reproduction. Vegetative reproduction occurs by fragmentation. Asexual reproduction, it occurs by three types. That is by sporangiospore, by chlamydospore, and by oidiospore. And sexual reproduction occurs by gametangial copulation. Thank you so much, students. We'll meet up again.